from him right
and
now.
And there was a bad Zabisco sign out there. Get that kid out of here.
Sure, there's more than one.
Stop it.
All right, we go back to action. This should be a great matchup here on WCW Monday Nitro. Fans still to come.
Oh, 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 he didn't wait. He didn't wait.
I said it should be a great match, but now Eddie Guerrero stomping on the back, of the head of Dean Malenko. And they're going to start this match right here, I guess.
I don't know what they're going to do, but Malenko can't stop. Look at him. Knocked out Cole from behind.
Eddie Guerrero jump-starting this. And, you know, Mike, today we've seen a very unusual man in Eddie Guerrero over the past couple of weeks.
Tony, a lot of people think that they know Eddie Guerrero, but let me educate the world. I've known Eddie for many years. I can tell you that he formed with the late Art Barr the most despised, the most hated tag team in the history of Lucha Libre, Mexican wrestling, the Gringos Locos. And in the case of Eddie Guerrero, what you've seen for the past year is not what you get.
Yeah, but let me ask you this. Why would a man like Eddie Guerrero, who we know and we've respected for so long, we know can wrestle, why in the world would he resort to tactics that we've just seen, getting a man from behind? I guess it has to do with what you were talking about.
Certainly does. Remember, Malenko and Guerrero, this is a long-term rivalry, but it was founded on mutual respect. That has evolved into personal animosity at this point between the two.
Yeah, well, I think he's a typical Guerrero. No emotional control whatsoever. Again, like Alex Wright, frustrated. They all come into WCW, want to be superstars, want the multi-million dollar contracts. Then when they find out it's not easy, they all get frustrated and they look for shortcuts. And that's what Eddie's doing too, being a Guerrero.
Well, he shortchanged, I think, his own nephew last week in Chavo Jr. I mean, he gave Chavo the match against Six and then stood by watching when Chavo Jr. was double-teamed by the NWO.
What have I been telling you for years? Money is thicker than blood.
And he even talked about blood. He talked about Sangre and the family association and promised that he would watch Chavo Jr.'s back. He let him down. He's letting a lot of people down right at this point.
Oh, Malenko got him down. Come on, Dean's got to get going.
Eddie, of course, just coming back from an injury, and we know the story of how Eddie Guerrero caused Dean Malenko back at Super Brawl to lose the Cruiserweight Championship to Six. That touched off a fierce rivalry that's taken this turn that seems incredible at this time, and Dean Malenko.
Guerrero, an attempt at a rolling DDT out of the corner, and Malenko just threw him away.
Yeah, because Malenko, you know, keep his composure here. He can't lose his head. Be a great mat wrestler. Get Eddie on the mat and wrestle him. Don't try to out-punch him and out-fly him.
It was Eddie Guerrero's interference that cost this man, Dean Malenko, the United States Championship, a frog splash off the top rope behind the referee's back, and that allowed Jeff Jarrett to capture the title.
So twice Eddie has been instrumental in Dean Malenko losing. That's why Malenko, when we saw him earlier today here at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, so fired up, so determined about this matchup he had. One of the biggest matches ever on Nitro for Dean Malenko. It's payback time. And Malenko back to work one more time, sending Guerrero down, who begs off. Malenko will have none of it.
Now he's too smart for that. Just stay on him. Stay on him. Be aggressive. If you don't let him up, that's a mistake. Don't throw Eddie Guerrero into the rope.
Malenko connected. Malenko with a cover here. One, two. And he only got a two, but he's back to the attack one more time. Later on tonight, fans, do not forget a big six-man tag featuring members of the NWO. Norton Bagwell and Tono against Flair, Mongo, and Benoit of the Horsemen. Here's a pickup. And
what a powerbomb!
Incredible impact with that powerbomb, holding Eddie Guerrero up into the air and then driving him down, the back of his head crashing off the canvas.
See, look at the emotions. He's slapping Eddie instead of hooking him.
Chavo Jr. has arrived. Unannounced, unexpected. I didn't even see Chavo here earlier.
I think Chavo probably wants some answers.
Hey, it's going to get... It's going to cause a DQ right there.
What's his purpose down here now? Oh, boy.
Obviously, the Guerreros are in together on this.
He runs Malenko into Chavo Jr. does Eddie, and now the Brain Buster. Oh, he hit hard when he hit Chavo, and Chavo is still down on the far side.
Eddie's headed to the top. Patented frog splash on the way.
Oh boy, got him. One, two, three. was in by coincidence, an accident.
Well, just look at the look on Chavo's face. I think it's rather obvious that Eddie Guerrero took advantage of both Dean Malenko and his own nephew.
I just see two Guerreros with no emotional control. Chavo Jr. had no business there. Malenko definitely distracted. Eddie should be disqualified.
Well, Eddie, with his arm around his nephew, will walk him out. And I'm sure Chavo, once he checks these cobwebs loose here, is going to have some questions for his uncle. Here it is.